Artificial Intelligence Act explained, how it will affect your product development. As the world's first AI regulation, the European Union AI Act is seen as a step that might slow innovations. After months of discussions, the AI Act took effect in August 2024. Whether you want to develop an AI product or already have one, this regulation will affect your business. The AI Act divides AI applications into four risk categories. Unacceptable risk AI systems are prohibited. High-risk AI systems come with specific legal requirements. Limited-risk applications require less regulation. And minimal-risk AI systems go largely unregulated. The AI Act is now active across all 27 European Union countries. However, the deadlines for meeting compliance differ. Prohibited AI applications must comply by February 2025, with obligations for general-purpose AI models starting in August 2025. Most of the Act's obligations, especially for high-risk systems, take effect in August 2026, and full compliance is required by August 2027. Non-compliance carries specific penalties. For example, up to 35 million euros, or 7% of a company's annual turnover. How will the AI Act affect your development? It depends on two factors: your role in the AI value chain and the risk category of your AI system. The AI Act defines specific roles for businesses. First, there are providers. They develop AI systems and place them on the market. Then, deployers, companies that use AI systems under their authority. Distributors and importers ensure AI systems are available on the European market. Product manufacturers integrate AI as a safety component into products requiring conformity assessment. And authorized representatives act on behalf of providers. The most responsibilities lie with providers. For high-risk systems, they should define potential risks, ensure high-quality data, maintain up-to-date technical documentation, enable automatic event recording for specific AI systems, ensure transparency and human oversight. Providers' obligations related to limited-risk AI involve two key aspects: ensuring that users know they interact with AI and making AI content identifiable to machines. And what about those cases when you already have an AI-enabled product? You might need to consider these steps. Identify the risk category of your AI system. Define your role and your contractor's roles in the AI value chain. Analyze the risks associated with your AI system. Renegotiate contracts with your AI development company if needed. Now, who will check your AI product for compliance with the AI Act? Each country in the European Union will establish national competent authorities with oversight from a new AI office. Yet the AI Act goes beyond risk categories and role identification. Take, for instance, sandboxes that help you test AI in safe environments. As a company, you should consider a budget that covers all expenses related to the testing stage. Meanwhile, your AI development company must keep test environments secure. Another important aspect of the AI Act is human oversight. Your data science team should consistently analyze AI decisions to ensure their relevance. The AI Act will also require updates to your product's technical documentation. For example, you might need to cover a wide range of diverse samples and a plan for human oversight. Moreover, the AI Act will impact highly regulated industries, such as healthcare. Want to dive deeper? Check out our article. Just click the link below this video. So, the AI Act is now a key part of the AI development landscape. And businesses have 1 to 3 years to prepare their current and future AI products to meet all regulations. Some believe the AI Act will pave the way for global regulations on AI. And what's your perspective on how it will influence AI development? Feel free to share your thoughts in the comments. Want to make your existing or future AI product compliant with the AI Act? Schedule a call with us to discuss your project.